accordance with the rules of procedure, the second reading debate is adjourned, and the bill is referred to the House Committee.
Secretary for Labour and Welfare. President, I move the second reading of the Occupational Safety and Occupational Health Legislation Miscellaneous Amendments Bill 2022. The bill seeks to amend the Factories and Industrial Undertakings Ordinance and the Occupational Safety and Health Ordinance to give employees better occupational safety and health protection. Whilst we have seen steady improvements in occupational safety and health over the years, the improvement trend has tapered in recent years. Fatal industrial accidents remain high. The number has been hovering around 20 cases a year for the past decade, with no sign of decline. The community generally considered one of the reasons is the sentences have been on the low side and not much of a deterrent effect to curb the offences. Besides, the OSH penalties, which have not been reviewed for well over 20 years, are lower than those in other developed jurisdictions. For those reasons, we have comprehensively reviewed the OSH penalty regime of the OSH legislation and revised the maximum fines of the legislation. There are 650 summary offences in above two ordinances. The administration has reviewed the maximum fines to ensure they will be commensurate with the seriousness of the offences and will achieve a deterrent effect. The amendments include: 1. For summary general duty offences, the maximum fines for employer GD provisions and employee GD provisions will be increased to $3 million and $150,000 respectively. 2. The seriousness levels of the summary offences and the maximum fines will be realigned. For employer-related offences, the maximum fines, depending on the seriousness, will be $25,000, $100,000, and $400,000, whereas the employee-related offences, the maximum fines, will be $10,000, $50,000, and $150,000. At present, the time bar for issuing summonses of summary offences is 6 months. We propose that it be extended to 1 year so as to allow sufficient time to conduct more in-depth investigations into those serious cases and provide the courts with sufficient evidence for considering whether immediate imprisonment penalty is warranted. One key proposal in the bill is to introduce penalties with sufficient deterrent effect of very serious OSH offences. We propose to amend the general duty provisions for employers, proprietors, and occupiers of premises and make them triable as indictable offences so the extremely serious OSH breaches can be put on trial at a higher level of courts. We also propose that the maximum fines for imprisonment terms be pitched at $10 million and 2 years respectively. Under the bill, the courts are required to take into account companies' turnover and, having regard to their scale of operation, impose a fine that has sufficient deterrent effect. The above provisions are merely targeting the small number of cases involving gross neglect of duties and very high culpability that led to very serious consequences, including employees' death. The government made the commitment in 2017 policy address to review the penalty regimes of relevant OSH legislation. We have conducted multiple consultations. The business and labour sectors generally agreed that there was a need to increase the penalties to enhance the deterrent effect, but there were diverse opinions on the magnitude. In formulating the proposals, we've considered the opinions that have been received. I urge members to support and pass the bill as soon as possible to accord employees better OSH protection. Subject to the passage of the bill, we will bring it into effect on the date it is gazetted.
I now propose a question to you that the aforesaid bill be read the second time. In accordance with the rules of procedure, the second reading debate is adjourned and the bill is referred to the House Committee. Government motion.